In today's video, I am going to explain anatomy and pathway of cranial nerves. There are 12 pairs of cranial nerves, right? 12 pairs. I want you to know that I am not going to talk about functions of cranial nerves. I will just explain names and pathway of cranial nerves. Let me explain from number 1 to number 12. Let's go to number 1 and number 2. Number 1 is olfactory nerve. Olfactory nerve, it's basically about smell. Number 2 is optic nerve. Optic nerve, it's about vision. Then, where is olfactory nerve going through? This tiny, tiny holes in bone. This tiny hole is called cribriform foramina. Cribriform foramina, there are tiny holes in bone. What about optic nerve? This nerve goes through this part. This is optic canal. Simple, right? Optic nerve, optic canal. This is number 2. Number 1, olfactory nerve. Cribriform foramina, right here. Let's go to next nerve. In this part, I'd like to explain number 3, 4, and 6. Why 3, 4, and 6? No 5? Let me explain that. There is reason. Cranial nerve number 3 is oculomotor. Oculomotor, number 3. Number 4 is trochlear. Trochlear. Number 6 is abducens. Oculomotor, trochlear, and abducens nerve are related to eye movement muscles. These nerves control eye movement muscles and they pass through same canal. That's here, this part. This canal is called superior orbital fissure. Superior orbital fissure. This is number 3, oculomotor. This is number 4, trochlear. This is number 6, abducens. They all pass through superior orbital fissure. So eye movement nerves penetrate superior orbital fissure. But optic nerve is different. Right? Optic nerve passes through optic canal. That's different. Oculomotor, trochlear, and abducens nerve passes superior orbital fissure. Now let's talk about number 5. Trigeminal nerve. This is trigeminal nerve. Trigeminal nerve. As name of this nerve suggests, there are 3 branches, 1, 2, and 3. Trigeminal number 1 is ophthalmic nerve. Ophthalmic nerve. What about number 2? This is maxillary nerve. Maxillary nerve. Number 3, mandibular nerve. Mandibular nerve, ophthalmic, maxillary, and mandibular nerve. Each nerve passes different hole. You know where ophthalmic nerve is passing through? Here. What is this? This is superior orbital fissure. I'm not going to write it down. Superior orbital fissure. How about maxillary nerve? This nerve penetrates round foramen. Round foramen. How about mandibular nerve? This nerve penetrates here, This is foramen oval. Foramen oval. I know it's a little bit hard to memorize, right? Number one, ophthalmic, superior orbital fissure. Number two, maxillary, round foramen. Number three, mandibular foramen oval. But it's just how it is. It's just the memorizing game. Anyway, this is trigeminal nerve. There are three branches. And I already talked about number six, abducens. This guy passes also superior orbital fissure. So let's go to number seven and eight. Number seven and eight pass here. Number seven is facial nerve. Facial nerve. Number eight is vestibular cochlear nerve. Vestibular cochlear nerve. Facial nerve is about the face muscles moving, okay, and so many other functions. Vestibular cochlear is about hearing and balance. Anyway, these two nerves pass here. This is internal acoustic meatus. Internal acoustic meatus. Meatus means hole. That makes sense, right? Facial nerve. Vestibular cochlear nerve pass through internal acoustic meatus. It's kind of simple, right? Now let me change the angle of picture a little bit and let's go to number 9, 10, 11. This is number 7 and 8. Let's go to 9, 10, 11. Number 9, 10 and 11. Number 9 is glossopharyngeal nerve. Glossopharyngeal nerve. Number 10 is famous one. That's vagus nerve. Number 11 is accessory nerve. Glossopharyngeal. Number 9. Vagus, number 10, accessory, number 11. Three nerves pass here. Oh my gosh, this is so important. This is jugular foramen. Jugular foramen. It is composed from two bones, temporal bone and occiput. So it's kind of a combination of two bones. Anyway, glossopharyngeal, number 9. Vagus, number 10. Accessory, number 11, they pass jugular foramen. Oh, by the way, accessory nerve also passes here, this big hole of occiput. This is foramen magnum. Foramen magnum, where brainstem and spinal cord pass through, right? Now let's go to the last one. That's hypoglossal nerve. Hypoglossal nerve is a little bit hard to see. That's here, this nerve, hypoglossal. This nerve controls the tongue movement muscles. This nerve penetrates hypoglossal canal. Hypoglossal canal. That's it. I explained the name of cranial nerves and pathway of nerves from 1 to 12. I know memorizing terminology is very hard to understand at first time. However, these terminologies are so important for cranial anatomy and functions. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.